Dear students, welcome to IC. Today's is CGD Constable, grant test number 57. English explanation is here. So let us start, sir. Listen carefully. Check this one. Direction is what? 76 to 78. In the following question, some of the sentences have errors and some have none. So find out which part of a sentence has an error and the number of that part is your answer. If there is no error, the answer is D, obviously 4. That is no error. So that is a thing, sir. Okay, fine. So Dilip has spent, first of all, sir, S-P-E-N-D, spent V1, spent both V2, V3, okay? So, has is there, sir, immediately, we should not check anything else, but make it a participle formation. So, V3, okay? So, Dilip has spent 6 years in Calcutta, but still he does not know many parts of the city. That is the thing. So, problem is in A. So, that is the thing, sir. 76, option number A is our answer. Clear? Next one. 77. The number of foreign tourists visiting India are increasing day by day during this tourist season. Okay? Check here. The number of foreign tourists. Remember one thing, sir. The number plus of plus plural subject. Okay, everyone. The plus plural subject. But the verb should be singular formation. The verb should be in singular formation. Okay, because what is there, sir? Remember the. So, the number of foreign tourists visiting India is increasing. Because when the number is there, sir, we are talking about the total amount, whole amount of something. Okay, so here the whole amount of foreign tourists. So, in that case, the number of foreign tourists visiting India is increasing day by day during this tourist season. Fine. So, that is the thing, sir. The number of plural subject, but verb should be singular. That's why is should be there. Problem is in B. Option number B is our answer. Clear? Next one. Come to 78. Unless you take interest into the studies, you will not succeed in the examination. Remember one thing, sir. Unless you take an interest into the studies. Why? Because here simply interest word is not a verb. Here it's a noun formation. And why? Because simply because after this, what is there? It's a preposition. Fine. So before any preposition, there can be a noun. Okay. So when a noun is there, a noun cannot. It can be, but normally it should be preceded by an article. So let us put an, because I is a vowel sound. So unless you take an interest, minimum interest, if you will not take into the studies, you will not succeed in the examination. That is the thing, option number B. So that is the thing. Here is our answer, sir. So 78, B is the answer. Clear? Next one. Come to 79 to 81. Check this one. In the following questions, out of the four alternatives, choose the one which best expresses the meaning of the given word. Gigantic or gigantic, people will use gigantic word. Please don't. Gigantic. Okay. Big, large. So here we have to find out what's a synonym. So colossal. Colossal meaning same, sir. Big or large. So in that case, option number A is the answer. Okay. Colossal. Now, sir, colorful meaning everybody knows, one by one. Chromatic, another synonym for the word colorful is chromatic. Fine. Beautiful meaning everybody knows, gorgeous, elegant. Fantastic meaning magnificent. Magnificent. Okay, that is a thing. So, in this case, sir, 79, option number A is the answer. Colossal and gigantic, both are similar thing, big or large. Okay, next one. Come to 80, sir. Stubborn. So options are timid and arrogant and adamant and angry. So refractory, obstinate. Stubborn meaning obstinate or refractory. What is the meaning, sir, of obstinate, refractory, stubborn? Meaning one person, you say something to him, but him or her, whatever it is, but he or she is not going to listen to any advice of any other person, and whatever he or she will think, he or she will do that thing द रिजल्ट और इफेक्ट कैन बी बैड ऑल्सो बट दैट काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स आर स्टबर्न नॉट लिसनिंग टू एनी वन सो दैट इज अ थिंग सो टिमिड टिमिड मीनिंग शाई और अनश्योर अबाउट एवरीथिंग दैट्स वाई दे आर टिमिड नेक्स्ट वन एरोगेंट मीनिंग रूड और सेल्फ प्राइड और प्राउड ओके एडामंट दैट इज द आंसर सर इनफ्लेक्सिबल And angry meaning everybody knows. Now, adamant meanings are inflexible, stubborn. Okay, those people who are not listening to any other people, they are adamant people. Option number C is the answer, sir. Stubborn, option number C, adamant is our answer as a synonym. Next one. Come to 81. Invariable is the word. Invariable meanings are changeless. Okay, meaning no change is there. Something which is always static, fine, that is the thing. So usual meaning accustomed, meaning which is something routine wise, dull, mundane, routine, every day is happening, usual thing, accustomed. Okay, universal meaning worldwide. Constant, obviously that is our answer, changeless. And similar meaning similarity, same thing, everybody knows. So invariable meanings are changeless. Whatever is changeless, that is constant. And whatever is constant, that is changeless. Option number C is our answer. So for question number 81, option number C, constant and invariable, both are synonymous. Okay, so next one. Everyone, come to direction 82 to 83. Check here in the following question. Choose the word opposite in meaning to the given word. So, what is the word, sir? Ephemeral. So, ephemeral meaning temporary or impermanent. Something which is not permanent. Okay. So, options are there, sir. Eternal meaning endless, ageless. Okay. Always it will be there. So I think you people have got the answer already. Let us know other meanings also. Transitory meaning lasting for a very short time. Lasting for a very short time. Next one, mortal. Sir, we all are mortal. Like one day we all will experience death. Okay, so deathly. And temporal meaning secular. Okay, another meaning is also there, sir, that is earthly. Okay, so whatever your choice you can take, because secular word is right now so much bad for India. So for 82, sir, ephemeral word is there. So for ephemeral, that is temporary or impermanent. Okay, so obviously, sir, something which is ageless or endless, eternal. Okay, there is no temporariness, always it will be there, permanency. So in that case, 82, ephemeral and eternal, both are antonymous. Next one, sir. Come to 83, latent. Latent meaning inactive. Listen, so many meanings are there. So latent meaning inactive, potentiality, or possibility. Now see, when we are telling there is a possibility in him or her, he or she has a potential, meaning they have not started yet anything. They have that inside them, but they have not started to show that potentiality or possibility of doing great things. Clear? That is a meaning. So obviously, sir, unspoken meaning which is not spoken, later, afterward, meaning something that will happen after some time. Implicit, meaning absolute. And obvious, meaning easily perceived or simply active, sir. When obvious thing will be there, sir? When people are already done something, people have made some obvious remark, meaning that is already done. Active, possibility is not there, potentiality is not there. It has already been shown that whatever they can do. So in that case, sir, obvious and latent both are antonymous words. Fine, everyone? In that way, not directly, but in this way. So 83, option number D is the answer. Next one, everyone, come to 84 to 86. Check here. In the following question, sentences are given with blanks to be filled in with an appropriate and suitable word. Four alternatives are suggested for each question. Choose the correct alternative out of the four. Let us find out. So for 84, we are getting these options. Climate, meaning everybody knows, sir. Weather. Weather, meaning also everybody knows whether or not it will happen or something like that. Weather, meaning also everybody knows atmospheric thing, atmospheric. And obviously, whither, meaning to what place. So, if dash permits, we will go out for a walk. So, see, climate is something that is a span of a long timing. Okay, like in Hyderabad, the climate is cool. Not cool, always. So, let it be cool. So, for so many years, that thing is continuously happening. So, if so many years, will you wait for a walk? The another person will go, yes or no? So, in that case, weather, sir, atmosphere of that particular time. Okay, so if weather permits, meaning if there will be no rain, if too much of sunshine will not be there, then we will go out for a walk. Okay, that is the thing. So, 84 option number C, sir, weather, it's so easy. Next one, come to 85, let us know all the meanings. Peripatetic, unsettled. Gypsy, meaning I think everybody knows, those people who are not settled from here to there, they are always moving, they are peripatetic. Obdurate, meaning stubbornly persistent. Or obstinate, not listening to anyone, inflexible. Okay, tenacious, meaning persistent or stubborn, same meaning, sir. Persistent or stubborn. Squeamish, meaning dainty, let us make it easy, sir. Fastidious. Okay, so his persuasive tone was able to tackle the boy whom other teachers had found obdurate. Okay, that is the thing, sir. Obdurate, meaning this boy actually stubborn, okay, not listening to anyone. But this teacher talked to him in a very friendly tone, persuasive tone, in a very appealing tone. Okay, so when that particular teacher has talked to this boy in a very appealing tone, then he easily tackled the boy. Okay, but other teachers had found him obdurate. Okay, like obstinate, inflexible, not listening to anyone. That is the thing, sir. So 85 option number B, sir, obdurate is the answer. Tenacious cannot be the answer, even the same meaning is there, but after tenacious something should be there, but obdurate is the thing. So directly we can use a tenacious behavior. Tenacious is adjective, that's why. So directly had found obdurate, that is also adjective, but it is directly coming or giving a sense. But after tenacious you have to use one noun, nonetheless tenacious word can't be used like that. So in that case, 85 option number B is the answer, obdurate. Okay, next one, sir. Come to 86, easier thing. Over, through, back on. See, fall back on. Write it, let us know the meaning first. Fall back on. Have resources to something when in difficulty. So, difficulty is there, time of difficulty is there, but you have resources to that. So, I always fall dash old friends in times of need. So, whenever there is a need, okay, of mine, then immediately resources in the name of old friends will come to me. That is the thing, sir. So, fall back on. Okay. So, whenever I will face any problem, I will go to my old friends and they will help me. Clear? That is the thing. 86 option number C is the answer, sir. Okay. So, 86 C is the answer. Next one. Come to 87 to 89 in the following question out of the four alternatives. Choose the one which best substitute for the given words or sentence. So, one word substitution, what here we are getting, sir. So, what is the thing? Phrase commencement of adjacent words with same letter. Okay, adjacent meaning one after another, similar, like one after another, like here one is there, adjacent. Okay, so pun, P-U-N, pun meaning प्ले ऑन वर्ड्स. वॉट इज द थिंग सर? द सन इज इन द स्काई. ओके, एंड इफ वी विल से लाइक दैट, यू आर द सन एंड मून इन माई लाइफ, मीनिंग यू आर इंपॉर्टेंट इन माई लाइफ. क्लियर? दिस काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स आर कॉल्ड पन. ओके, यूजिंग वन पर्टिकुलर थिंग एंड कंपेयरिंग दैट थिंग विथ योर ओन लाइफ. फाइन, दैट इज अ थिंग सर. सो एलिटरेशन, एलिटरेशन इज द आंसर सर. सो व्हेन यू आर कमेंसिंग ऑफ एडजस्टमेंट वर्ड विद द सेम लेटर, ओके, दैट इज अ थिंग कॉल्ड एलिटरेशन. ट्रांसफर्ड एपिथेट, डिस्क्रिप्टिव वर्ड एंड ऑक्सीमोरॉन, कॉन्ट्राडिक्टरी टर्म्स. There is in language, there is so many terms that are contradictory to one another. Okay, that is a thing called oxymoron. So 87, option number B, alliteration is our answer. Next one, sir. Come to question number 88, everyone. A specialist who tests eyesight. So, doctor of eyes, ophthalmologist, everyone. I think everybody knows this one already. So, ophthalmologist. Optical meaning visual. Okay. Ichthyologist meaning a zoologist who studies fishes. So fish only, don't say fishes, everyone, always fish. Okay, next one, neurologist, medical specialist, studying or observing the nervous system of human body. Okay, sometimes they're operating also. So in that case, sir, 88, option number B, ophthalmologist is our answer. Next one, come to 89, sir. A wall built to prevent the sea or a river from flooding an area. I think everybody knows that. Dam, then mound, then dike, then embankment. Dam meaning, sir, obstruct with. That can be anything, not only water. Okay, next one, mound, small natural hill. If you people will go to Warangal from Hyderabad, you people will find out so many mounds here and there, both the sides of the highway. Yes or no? That is a thing called mound. Okay, so small natural hill. Dye meaning coloring. Okay, and obviously, sir, embankment is the answer. So, wall built to prevent the sea or river from flooding an area, that is called embankment. Dam is something different, sir. Okay, dam is a reservoir thing where water is stored. Okay, whenever there is a need, they will open the gates and water will come out. That is different thing. So, when water should not, so to prevent the water from sea or river, wherever the wall is built, that is a thing called embankment. Fine. So 89D is the answer. Next one, sir. Come to 90 to 91. In the following question, groups of four words are given. In each group, one word is wrongly spelled. Let us find out the wrongly spelled word. Synonymous. This is the thing, sir. Okay. Meaning is what? Similar. As we already know. So obviously, this one is the answer. That is the wrongly spelled word only. In examination, don't waste time, but here we should know. Anonymous, sir, meaning nameless. Unanimous, incomplete agreement. So if I will say one sentence like, after observing her great educational background, the whole staff of the university unanimously appointed her. Okay, so that is the thing. All were in full agreement that let us take her as our faculty or something like that. Okay, and pseudonymous. Pseudonymous meaning a fictitious name. Fictitious meaning, I think everybody knows, taken any other name and writing down. Okay, like if you are writing a poem, okay, if you are writing a story or anything sarcastic thing or poem or story, okay, like just complaining against government, then you should not take your own name. So a fictitious name or pseudonymous name you can take, and then you can write down. Okay, bloggers, actually bloggers are not using their own name while targeting the government or any other religious construction. So that is a thing. 90, option number A is the answer. So synonymous, that is a wrongly spelt word. Next one, come to question number 91, everyone. Let us find out the wrongly spelt word. Yes or no? Check here. What is there wrongly spelled? So let us find out wrongly spelt word. Condone is the word, sir, everyone. The meaning is giving excuses. Okay. Condemn. Express strong disapproval. Next one, contempt. There is nothing like that, sir. The word is contempt. Okay, that is a thing, sir. Okay, so contempt meaning, sir, disrespect. And content, I think everybody knows, any kind of substance is called content. If writing thing is there, that is also a content. Okay, so substance. So substance. Writing is also, writing substance is also there, na? So that is a thing. So for 91, sir, option number C is the answer, because that is the wrongly spelled word here. Fine. Next one, sir. Come to 92 to 94. In each of the following questions, some part of the sentence is in bold. Out of the given alternative, choose the alternative that improves the bold part. If there is no improvement, choose option D. So question number 92, the colorful flags added gaiety of the occasion. Gaiety. Gaiety meaning, sir, merriment. Just a second. Gaiety meaning merriment, colorful. Okay, something which is really colorful. So the colorful flags added gaiety of the occasion. So in that occasion, people are happy, people are making merriment, people are enjoying. So those colorful flags are adding that thing. Fine. So positivity. So adds gaiety, added to the gaiety. Have added gaiety, no improvement. Check here, sir. Added to the gaiety of the occasion. Added to the gaiety of the occasion, because gaiety is a noun. Before noun, obviously one particular article should be there. So in that case, added to the gaiety. The party or the occasion is already happy, filled with happiness. So in that one, sir, added to the gaiety, meaning those flags, those colorful flags are adding more merriments in this occasion. So that is the thing. 92, option number B is the answer. Next one, come to 93. Thousands these machines are gathering dust in stock rooms. So thousands are there, sir, and obviously everybody knows thousands of these machines. Okay, option number A is the answer, sir. Thousands of these machines are gathering dust in stock rooms. 93, option number A is the answer. Okay, that is a thing. Fine. Next one. Come to question number 94, everyone. He kept tell us for his operation in the most graphic detail. So he kept tell us, like one person is continuously or keeping telling us one story of whatever it is. Here it is operation or something like that. So when anyone is talking about a story, so see, sir, operation is actually a story. So that particular person is actually talking about a story. So about a story, and that story is what, sir? Operation. Fine. So he kept tell us for his operation in the most graphic detail. So he kept telling us. Just remember, after the word keep, we can use gerund directly. We can use gerund or verb plus ing directly. Okay, as we can use that directly. So in that case, 94, option number B is our answer. He kept telling us about his operation in the most graphic detail. Fine. So 94, option number B is the answer. Next one. Come to question number 95 to 99. In the following question, you have been given a passage. In the passage, some of the words have been left out. First, read the passage over and try to understand what it is about. Then fill in the blanks with the help of the alternatives given. So here, sir, what we are getting? Water shortages. It is about water shortage. So water shortages dash to recent studies hit the poor population hardest. So here we are getting these options, sir. Responding, meaning reacting. According, meaning something which is reported, by report, something which is reported. So, sir, I think you people already got it. recent studies, and that recent studies has been reported. So according to that, so here we have to use according to recent studies. Option number B is our answer. Okay, for 95. Other words are there. Check agreeing meaning. No different opinions are there. Single opinion is there. Each and everyone is in agreement. Okay, pertaining meaning relevant or bear on. Bear on. Fine. So in this case, sir, 95, option number B, according is the answer. So water shortages according to recent studies. 95, option number B is the answer, sir. Next one. So right now come to 96, and what we got in 95, everyone? Water shortages according to recent studies. Okay, so that is the thing. Okay, let us remember, let us go through then. So water shortages according to recent studies hit the poor population hardest, both economically and in terms of their health. They are hit hardest dash the dash of impure water. So they are hit hardest by the. So by is here, sir, already. So that is the answer only. Hardest by the dash of. So let us see for 97 what will be there. So here, sir, let us remember once again. So water shortages according to recent studies hit the poor population hardest, both economically in terms of their health. They are hit hardest by the, let us find out right now, impure water. So nourishment cannot be the word, sir. Comfort meaning ease. If impurity is there, comfort will be not there. Effects is the answer, sir. Result, that is a noun thing, sir. Okay, and facility meaning any kind of installation that is giving you ease or comfort. Okay, so that is the thing, sir. So for 97, option number C is the answer. The effects of impure water. Okay, the impure water is there, and the effects or the result of it, and what is the result? They got hit hardest. Fine. So for 97, option number C, effects is the answer. Okay, let us continue, sir. So here what we got, 95 according, okay, so let us read. Water shortages according to recent studies hit the poor population hardest, both economically in terms of their health. They are hit hardest by the effects of impure water, and in some parts of Asia they dash 20 to 60 times more for water dash. So for let us come to 98, sir. So Asia, they dash 20 to 60 times more for water. Pay, obtain, restrict, return. Okay, restrict meaning, I think everybody knows, hold or limiting or curbing. Okay, return meaning everybody knows. Obtain meaning is also hold or find or get. Okay, so that is the whole thing. So in 98, sir, let us find out. So, and in some parts of Asia, they dash 20 to 60 times. So they pay 20 to 60 times more. So here in Asia, we are paying for water, and that is the thing, 20 to 60 times more for fresh water. So that is the thing. 98, option number A is the answer. Okay, next one. So let us remember once again. So water shortages according to recent studies hit the poor population hardest, both economically and in terms of their health. They are hit hardest by the dash of impure water, by the effects of impure water. Okay, and in some parts of Asia, they pay 20 to 60 times more for water dash those in wealthier district. So for, beyond, above, than. So comparison is going on. Than those in wealthier district, than is the answer, sir. So for water, than those in wealthier district, that is the thing. So for 99, option number D, than is the answer. Why than? Because comparison is going on. That's the thing, sir. Let's next question. Come to question number 100. Out of the four alternatives, choose the meaning of the given idiom. To make short work of, to get an easy victory of. Okay, so that is the thing, sir. To get an easy victory. So you are getting a victory, but the opponents are not so hard or hard to get. So that is the thing. So you are getting an easy victory. So that is the thing. So 100 number, option number A is the answer. Fine. And that's all for this set.